Davide claims to have built the ultimate chatbot with Azure SQL database and AI. Come see how he made me believe this this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Davide, a product manager on the SQL team. Davide, thanks so much for coming back.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Likewise. And today, we're going to be talking about another AI topic, which is no surprise with you these days. You're
right.
Full of AI topics, but this one is about building the ultimate chatbot.
Yes. And I know I'm flexing a bit, but it's a cool topic. So I really want to show you it. So as soon as possible, I have exactly zero slides, just geeky code.
So. Amazing. Okay, so before we get into the geeky code, which we all want to see, help us understand the problem statement a little bit. Like the way I understand it is like, we have customers or users, and they really want to chat with their data.
That's right.
But it's a little bit complicated.
Yeah, because AI applications are usually very good at understanding unstructured data, like text and you know, reading through it and giving you a summary, but are less able to actually query the data that is stored in a structured way, like in a database or other formats, but in our case, a database. So I think I have a very nice demo that shows how to put everything together so you can build the ultimate chatbot.
The ultimate chatbot.
Okay, let's take a look. Yeah. So the data I'm using is from a conference, actually a conference I went last month in Germany. So there are a bit of bot session in English and in German. And that makes a little bit more interesting the query that we can do in kind of the dialogue that we can have with AI. So I already started my chatbot. As you can see, it's very geeky, just a terminal application here. And let's start with the question. Hi. So just imagine this is a chatbot I have built on the data of my conference. So it doesn't know much anything else about the world, but it's very good at the data of my conference. So I use the session and the title and the abstract and the speaker name to basically feed the data to my bot and see what happens. So hi. I'm a conference about SQL and AI, so presumably I want to learn how to use AI with my own data. And let's say which is stored in Azure SQL. So I'm chatting. Can you help me? Here we go. And let's see what happens. So it's searching from the memories. And what will happen is that, first of all, I injected some memories here, as you can see, the debug, to basically connect to OpenAI. And now it's finding that there is something about Semantic Kernel and Azure SQL support for vectors, which is in public preview now. And it learned from the memory injected because the AI model are trained up to a specific point in time. Mm-hmm. And this one specifically is trained up to April 2003. So we just released the vector. It couldn't know about this new feature. So I have injected some memories. And now it's starting to use this memory to answer me. And in fact, it's telling me, absolutely, using AI with Azure data, it's possible. And you, besides doing the obvious stuff, you can start to use Semantic Kernel with SQL Server and vectors that are now in public preview. So this is something that is what we say unstructured because it just comes from the AI model reading through the basically your question and answering with the already acquired knowledge. But now let's do something very cool here.
Okay.
Let's say, cool, is there any session about that at the conference?
So you didn't tell it what? You just said about that.
That, yes. So let's see what's happening. It's searching for the memory. There is nothing in the memory about this specific question. But it's figuring out it has to call a function, I'll show you in a second, that is looking to find similar sessions to some topic. Mm. And the topic is AI with Azure SQL. That's fantastic. The topic is something that the AI came up on its own and is using it to call the procedure that I created or the function I created with that parameter.
Wow.
So this is pretty cool. We're still in the realm of unstructured data, but we are starting to see the AI being able to use some tools, in this case, a store procedure that I created. And yes, it's giving me a lot of session, building AI-ready application by Moasma, integrating user AI, and so on and so forth. So let's say that we are interested in this topic. And of course, what we want to do is now start to say, hey, in which track is that session? Because then probably I want to go
Maybe
to all the
to
sessions.
That's right. Sessions on that track.
So in which topic?
Which track?
That's right. In which track is the first session? Let's see. First of all, again, it's able to understand what is the first. And this is the query that you, as also a human, you think, okay, probably I need to run something like that. Now, depending on the real schema, you will translate in your mind in real T-SQL.
Right.
That's
right.
Exactly what's happening. So this is what the AI is thinking to do, and this is what actually is doing. So using JSON value, because my track information is stored in a JSON data in my Azure database. So it's able to actually come up with a right query to answer my question, and you go. The building AI-ready application is in the analytics and data science track. It's pretty cool.
Wow.
So we're moving from unstructured data, like asking you about a general topic, asking you information about that topic, and then moving to structured query by querying the data that I have in my database. So another question.
Do I have to pause you? Because I want to understand. So at the beginning, you talked about memories.
Yes.
Can you explain a little bit?
Yeah, sure. Oh, so you want to go in the code right now, yes? Let me show you. So this is the code I have behind the scene. And at some point, I said initializing long-term memory. And here you can see some memories I injected, like that Azure SQL support for vector is now in public preview, which means taking this information, converting into a vector that now can be stored in Azure SQL so that the AI can actually search through this vector, but in a way that is not precise because I never searched for that specific text, right? I searched for something that is somehow similar to that text.
Mm. So you can supplement the knowledge of your with like memories.
Yes,
and
yes,
in this case, it's just text, but maybe you could point it to another document.
Yes, it could be honestly everything. Now here I'm using text because it's the easiest, but it could be even images if you want sounds or PDFs, whatever. Mm-hmm. So you can really feed your AI model with whatever you have about your company or your data. Mm-hmm. So the AI model understand how it can answer to your question based on that information that you are providing.
Okay, makes sense.
So this is something you can do. We say you are grounding the model with some knowledge that you want it to have, but also you have some existing knowledge in the database, basically like all the sessions that are at this conference, where you probably don't want to really feed that information as memory. It's more like something that is available here to query. Mm-hmm. And so that's exactly what we are doing when we are building this chatbot and saying, if I get into the plugin section, and all of this is available on GitHub.
Yes, this was my next question. Yes. So this was about like, how does it know like, I have this function and this function that I can go call?
Yeah, here we go. So you decorate a function, for example, this one, kernel function as something that can be used by, in this case, Semantic Kernel, which is our orchestrator to connect to OpenAI and build and execute query. And you are explaining, this function can be used when you want to get information about the session that are not available via other means, like a stored procedure. So this is the table that I have in my database. This is the content that you can expect to have. And then even more information on the extract structure, what is in the details column, and for example, the track information, and how it should correctly query the column to avoid any errors.
But you're doing this in plain text, not in like code?
Well, I'm doing just like I would be explaining to you, right? Because
wow.
I'm explaining the AI model, how to actually, or I'm teaching it if you want, correctly create a query and query my database so it is able to do on its own when needed. Right.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
So basically, we are using Semantic Kernel as an orchestrator and then decorating some function as tools that they can be used by the AI model that we are using. And we are feeding this additional metadata to let the AI model how our database is structured. So you can really then basically have any question. If I go back to my sample here, let's say, can you list all the sessions in, well, let's even keep the mistake in that track, and then it will run a query, and now mixing again a structure and a structured data, and basically just answering your question. We have some delay here because we need to re-authenticate the database, but here we go. Now you have all the session, and now this is interesting. I don't understand German, maybe you do, but definitely.
Oh, no, I do not.
Yeah, so the next thing I would definitely do is, okay great. Can you list only the one in English? But I just want to highlight how natural is my dialogue with the chatbot. Mm-hmm. I'm not thinking, oh, this is artificial intelligence, so I need to be careful on what I ask. I'm just asking, right? Yeah. And he's doing a
moving. It figures it out. Wow.
Yes, this is pretty cool. Like he figures out how to actually extract the languages in the details.
Wow.
So it's very natural. So that's why I kind of jokingly call the ultimate chatbot, because imagine doing this on a company data, like an insurance, healthcare, whatever. You can really have people interacting with the database in a very natural language. And this is possible in SQL because you're mixing structured and unstructured data in just one place. And I think it's fantastic. Honestly.
Amazing. Yeah, no, it is pretty ultimate.
I told you.
Yes. So like if I am watching this and I'm like, oh my gosh, I need this tomorrow or yesterday.
Yeah.
Like, what's your advice?
Yeah, just go take exactly this sample that is published on GitHub already. Become familiar with it, and then change the data so it points to your table. Add your own data, add your metadata, and basically, you know, take it from there. And you know, I'm really curious to see what people can build, because the sky's the limit here.
Wow, that's
yeah,
so
it's cool.
Yeah, where your creativity is really
right.
A big piece
yes.
of this.
Yes. And mostly it's not even done in code, because you need to be also very good at explaining. Yes. So it also helps maybe, you know, IT folks to be more, easy to understand to everyone.
I was wondering where you were going to go with that.
Yeah, there. Well, I'm one of those, so you know.
Awesome.
Anyway.
Well, thanks so much, Davide. My mind has been blown. That was very cool. That was definitely the ultimate chatbot, so I think you earned that title for it. Hey, viewers, if you like this episode, give it a like, leave a comment, let us know what you think, but more importantly, go check out this sample and try it with your own stuff. And we'd love to hear either via GitHub or the comments, what you think. So check it out, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.